Alrighty, YouTube guys, Gavin here. Today we're going to be talking about a awesome artist. The artist we're looking at today is Princess Nokia. The album we're looking at today is 1992 Deluxe. And just a little bit of background. She lived in East Harlem, lower side of New York. And at 15, she moved out of her stepmom's house and moved into her dad's place, which was basically kind of like the starting point or like the beginning of Princess Nokia. The first thing I'm talking about are my first impressions of the album. My first impression stemmed from, she had a really interesting artist name. It was rather unique, and I kind of wanted to know more about her and more about her music. And so that's kind of where, you know, some of the first impressions started from. My first impression of the album basically was, I thought she was hype. She was kind of like a little more hype, but then she turned out to be more like this 90s hip-hop vibe going on, and like the album was so much more intimate and like telling than I was wrapping my mind up around the album, so that was really cool. Alrighty, so the next thing to talk about are the lyrics. The lyrics I've pulled up today are the song Bart Simpson. Let's jump right into this. So basically it starts off, rotten apple to the core, damn I've been a fuck up, getting picked for last in gym, I can't even do a layup. Riding on my sneakers, being sneaky with my teachers, smoking weed under the bleachers, cutting out and gluing pictures. Carrying my CD, sucking on an hour later, sour apple was the flavor. Scribbling on doodle paper, trying hard to pay attention. So like I said, this album was relatively intimate in the sense that it kind of felt like, you know, it kind of felt like a diary a little bit. Some of the tracks are more, they're more relative to some of her mainstream stuff, but, you know, the rest of the album is just like the complete insight into this girl's world and, you know, With that being said, like, you know, the album is called 1992 Deluxe, and I think it's like a homage, to who she is and who, you know, this person we're kind of being introduced to. She's not super, super mainstream, so, you know, she has this, you know, where a lot of artists kind of, get nostalgic about is like the up and coming and the beginning of things is where, like, you know, you can either choose to tell everyone who you are right away, or you can just be like, you know, oh, I'm this mysterious person. And, you know, the people who get to choose, the people get that time to choose, I mean, why not let everyone into your world a little bit? Why not let anyone know, you know, where you come from and who you are? You know, it's very interpersonal thing, and I really appreciate it, especially considering that some of her other tracks are just a little bit like, you know, they're not nearly as intimate. I mean, they are kind of intimate considering that, you know, the sexual exploiting a little bit, and like the chorus goes, I carumba, Bart Simpson with the shits, I carumba man, you can go and suck my dick, and skating down the street being mischievous as shit. This is as good as it's gonna get. Always cheat on your test. Don't be like the rest. Ain't no teacher's pet. Next in reference to pop culture and things like that nature. So the next thing I'm talking about is the band similarities. Basically, if you like these bands or artists, you might like this album / artist. Sound is more like 90s hip hop, lots of bass, and like I said, it's kind of indie in a sense, literally and figuratively. I think she was independent for a while, and she was recording a lot of her albums. She grew up in the place where hip hop essentially started, and you could totally hear it in her sound. You know, it's a She talks about it a lot, and it's definitely a huge influence on her music and in this album as well. Yeah, it kind of sounds like if Nicki Minaj made 90s hip-hop. Alrighty, so the next thing I'm talking about is my favorite song off this album. So right off the bat, my favorite song is probably going to be Bart Simpson. I really like that song. I really like the flow. I think it tells a lot about who she is and, like, you know, where she comes from and stuff like that. A couple other songs that I like off this album were Foggy Denim, Green Line, and honorable mention, ABCs of New York was also really good. And yeah, so some final thoughts. Overall, great album, great artist. You know, she's definitely on the come up. I'm definitely excited to see where she goes from here, what she's going to do next. This album, we give it like a 4. My scale is 1 through 5, by the way, so 4 is a pretty good it's a pretty good standard. Alrighty guys, if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. If you have any suggestions for movies, music, games alike, leave in the comment section. I'll be sure to check them out. And don't forget to subscribe. Peace.